Greetings, saints. Greetings one more time. Here's what the Bible says. It says something very interesting when you read the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 6 and 7. It says, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. Verse 7, now it says, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and will guard your minds in Christ Jesus. Now, this is the word of the Lord, saints, and here is something very interesting that it says. It says, when you begin to be anxious about something, when you begin to be anxious about anything at all, you know, it doesn't matter what the situation you are confronted with. It may be a situation that seems to be too deep, that is seeming to be out of control. You know, it doesn't matter what the situation is. The Bible says, by prayer and by petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. He is willing and He is able and He is waiting that you come before Him in prayer. You kneel before Him, you lift up your hands and you say, God, here is the situation. I don't know what to do. It's beyond my control. It's just beyond my mind and my heart, and I hand it over to you. You know, and when you hand over your anxieties unto Him, when you hand over your situations unto Him through prayer, through petition, and through thanksgiving, the Bible says in exchange, when you have presented those situations to Him, in exchange, the Bible says, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and will also guard your mind. In other words, you will be overwhelmed by the exchange which the Lord will give you. When you give Him your situations, you give Him the situations that make you anxious. In exchange, He gives you His peace, the peace that surpasses human understanding. And you will be filled with that peace, both in your heart and also in your mind. You'll begin to calm down. You'll begin to have clarity, the clarity of the vision. You'll begin to develop strength. You'll begin to develop might. And the glory of God will be upon your life. Here's the reason why I say that. You remember when Moses went up to the mountain to pray, and the Bible says he prayed for 40 days and 40 nights, praying before God on the mountain. And the Bible says when he came down, oh my God, he was so filled with the glory of God. People will think you have this new makeup. It's not makeup, it's the glory of the Lord. You know, you begin to be filled with the glory of God. Because yes, something that is very important for us to understand is that prayer does not change God. God remains the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Definitely. You know, but prayer changes us. We become better people. We become better speakers. We become better listeners. We even look better. We even think better. You know, our hearts, they become guarded by peace of God. And our minds, they also become guarded by the peace of God. You know, we become clear on that which we do. The might of God becomes our might. The hand of God becomes our hand. We become more like Him. You remember the song, oh Lord, I want to be like you. Oh Lord, I want to be like you. So the more we pray, the more we become like God. And the more we become fused or filled in with the glory of God. And when the glory of God is upon us, He multiplies our steps and He magnifies our words. Our words become so amplified. Our actions become amplified. Even our wars, you know, when we fight, our weapons, they no longer become just the weapons on earth, but they become the weapons of warfare. In other words, even prayer on itself. Prayer is a weapon, is the greatest weapon you can carry every day. Before you leave, you go to work. Before you leave, you go to that conference. Before you leave, you go to that interview. Before you leave, going to that office, make sure that you take this prayer with you. You take this weapon with you, and you put it inside your belly. And inside your belly, you know, the rivers of living waters will begin to flow. If you take this arm, or you take this army, or you take this prayer, you know, prayer is basically a weapon. It's the greatest weapon you can ever have. You know, pray every day. Pray without ceasing. In the morning, begin to thank God and begin to petition what you would need for that day. Need of protection. The need of guidance. The need of the right type of association, you know, then it doesn't matter what it is. All you need to do is to present your prayers before God. You don't need to be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer, by petition, and with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Bless you.